going Rob.
He's going Rob.
Yeah.
Way better matchup for Min Min.
Absolutely. One of Min Min's, you know, few polarizing matchups.
Right.
Min Min either loses pretty hard or wins incredibly.
Such a bad matchup where MKLeo decided, you know what, I'm going to pick up Rob for Min Min.
That's insane. You're so right, though. We saw the Leo Rob come out first time at Double Down versus...
Justice?
No, versus... Proto. Proto in Grand Finals.
Yeah, you're
so,
right.
This is basically just Proto MKLeo, if you think about it. Tekken's the hero. But we'll see here. We might see the Ice Climbers come out, depending on how poorly this goes. But so far, Peckham up tremendous. 86 to 25.
I feel like Luis takes a couple seconds. He's heating up the vehicle. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. You think Min Min's got gyro combos? I can't imagine she has gyro combos.
She probably got, like, some sauceless gyro combos, but there has to be one or two. Like,
she's got...
The Labber's definitely figured it out.
She's definitely got, like, F-toss into dragon arm to kill you at, like, 40.
What if you do, like, Z-drop Nair into dragon arm laser?
Maybe. That could be cool. Peckham taking the first stock in quick order, pairing the Nair. Clearly comfortable in this matchup.
Oh, you're not making that back. Great gyro throw.
Gyro just covers so much of that space where Min Min wants to tether.
We got two high tiers on the character on the screen right now.
It's two top tiers, man. These characters are bullshit in their own ways.
Okay, one high tier and one top tier.
Which one's the high tier?
Min Min.
Oh, dude, I think Min Min's top tier.
Really?
I think Min Min's top tier if you have a secondary. Min Min's a top tier counterpick character. You have somebody to deal with her couple bad matchups? She's fucking broken. Like, I mean, Peckham's showing that, pulling out the Ice Climber to beat Demon earlier.
Wasn't Peckham the highest California player at Genesis 10?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think so. He was fucking cooking.
17th out of 2,000? 17th out of 1,500, something like that? Peckham hanging on for dear life here at the edge, though, against this, this Rob.
Damn! Okay! Put the blasters on him! Now, look at this. Louis Money actually taking the lead after a pretty questionable start.
Does he have those?
Oh, he don't, but it's still connected. The second Nair's still connected.
Still an advantage, though.
Rob probably top five secondaries. I think Rob top five even without secondaries.
Really? Dude, I'm a Rob hater. I think Rob loses too many matchups. Both these characters have very polarizing matchups. You have one character to cover those couple bad matchups, though. These characters are insane. Rob's one of those characters that can always just win, right? You have a winning-ass matchup, and then you get hit with a gyro, and you die immediately.
I think you just have, you just gotta give credit to players like Zomba, Big Boss, and Anathema.
Absolutely.
Where they stick with Rob, and they make Rob look way more broken.
In every matchup.
Up air, going to connect. Louis Money taking game one.
Catching a double jump. Yeah, man, Zomba, especially recently, you know, beating some of Rob's impossible matchups. Still losing to Bayo, but it's okay. Beating Sonics, beating some of the matchups that, you know, he used to go, he used to go Lucina for.
But making Sonic Rob look even is
crazy.
Like, making it look even, that was disgusting. At Genesis, I don't know what I was watching.
Bro, I was there in the crowd. I was like, what is this?
You were there?
Yeah, I was there. I was like, there's no way. Anyway, going into game number two, we'll see if Peckham has made the adaptation. Starting off so strong in the last game, starting off strong again in this game, but is he going to be able to carry it through and find a stock?
I think it was even. There was just moments where Rob was doing Rob things. Like,
yo,
I will kill you right here.
You see, every time Luis gets in, it's just immediate, like, 80%. He gets the Nair into gyro into forward air and just keeps advantage stating.
Wait, you can hold on to gyro while throwing your arms out?
While throwing the B arm, right? I think it's only the B arm. If you're in chat, let me know. I think you can only throw the B arm out while you've got gyro.
Oh, hold on. Has to go for a jump here.
Oh! Down air gonna take that stock, trading with the Nair.
I saw Peckham's face. He was like, well, I'll take that.
Bro, Rob down tilt, if he gets close enough to use it in this matchup, seems very impressive.
Ooh. Letting go of shield a little too early, getting hit with a full charge laser. That did like 30.
That's crazy. Going for it? Where's the mash? Good. That move should never kill. Trying to grab the gyro, but just gonna kick it away instead. Peckham doing a really good job playing keep away here in the corner. You're Peckham in this situation, you're just taking damage.
Yeah, right? Just try to avoid, how can I say, these kill confirms. Just try to play around the win condition of Louis Money, where he's doing great so far, surviving 130, and Luis already at his potentially last stock here. If he gets hit with his megawatt.
Oh, he's got two stocks, but almost. Ooh. Okay, Peckham hanging on. Peckham pulling out all the tricks. We see him doing, ooh, mixing up his timings on his double arms, doing a up-B cancel megawatt from ledge. Damn, looking dominant in this game number two. Taking all that extra credit.
I'm telling you, Luis just hasn't been able to get the ROM shenanigans going on. This is a very honest ROM that we're seeing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Luis not wanting to take the time to set up gyro, or not having the space to set up gyro. Just being forced all across the stage. Still not going to find it. 179. Nair will start killing soon, though, and then Fair going to take it.
One on the board here for Luis. Love to see it. Oh, that was clean.
Dude, he's moving. He wants this win. Luis not being in grand finals would be crazy, but I won't get ahead of myself.
If there's anyone to do it, it's definitely Peckham forward air. Oh, the back air's enough.
Oh, one more. Yeah, that's it. Damn, Luis robbing that stock. He was at 30% when the edge guard started.
You know what you signed up for when you play Min-Min, bro. True. It's gonna happen. You gotta pay your taxes at least once every year.
She's got one weakness, and that's it.
Now he's playing on overdrive. Oh, ads.
That megawatt gonna take it for sure. Peckham.
God, damn, we doing a lot of. Are we trying to get
Min-Min?
Ads. To all my subscribers, thank you for being here.
Are we going to see the swap to Palu? Just like in the Quinset, Quinn lost a game, Palu came out. Do we see the same thing from Luis? I see the hover. Yeah, and we are going to see the Palu going into game number three. But Peckham, newly warmed up in this matchup.
Yeah. Different situation, though, where Luis actually took game one. Yep. With the secondary, so a little bit more room for comfort. But like you said, already used to playing as Palutena, I will say not throwing shots at Quinn, a much better Palu in this case.
Another caliber of Palu, to be sure. Ooh. Catch the jump. Yeah, it's really interesting, though. You know, Luis, all through tonight, has shown such an insane mastery of ledge trapping. Really just keeping people on the ledge for 90% of the time. We'll see if he's able to do that to Peckham here.
Explosive flame connects. Okay, another one.
Oof. Already at 120.
It just seems like Palu is way more mobile.
Absolutely.
Oh, hold on. I'm surprised that laser didn't come out.
Oh, man. Peckham doing his best, but Palu, so much more threatening in some of these situations, also just able to weave in and out a lot better. Not that air drift, paying huge dividends.
Especially in the air, right? And the jumps in
exactly.
The air seem so much faster.
Yeah, I mean, Rob just so clunky in comparison when you look at these, like, full hops and these short hops coming out from Luis. Ooh. And Luis, one big difference you're noticing here is Luis is not having any trouble getting out of the corner here against Peckham. Ooh. You notice versus Quinn, Peckham was keeping Palu off stage in the corner for so long. Gonna take that stock and even the score. Luis immediately getting on stage, getting to center.
Now at 0%, this is where Palu shines. It's just about getting that window of opportunity. We already know Nair up air.
Yep.
Is gonna be able to do so much damage.
If you're Peckham, you have one thing on your mind, don't get nared.
Right? Avoid that win condition.
It's crazy to me that I didn't know that Nair clanked with Min Min's arms. That's absurd.
Okay, oh, there it is.
It.
Back air.
Quick 55.
So much damage. Have to respect it and go for the air dodge.
grabbing the wrong way. Peckham will take the stage. Oh, barely missing the grab.
Oh, double dash attack. What a great burst option here from Palu. Gets the down tilt. And now off stage situation where Peckham feels a little bit awkward. Luis allowing them to get back onto the stage.
Yeah, like you said earlier, the explosive flame really coming out to force the jump from Min Min, giving her really one chance to recover.
It seems like conditioning, where right now, after the explosive flame, he's like, okay, I'm gonna let you grab the ledge, but when I need that read, I'm not. I'm gonna nair.
Absolutely. It's the set play we're coming out here. And again, in a best of five set, when you're tied up like this, you really need all of those reads, all of that conditioning you can set up.
Second stock, last stock situation here on game three, which I feel like is a pivotal stock for both of them.
Absolutely.
Whoever gets the advantage here is going to be chilling.
Peckham doing a great job keeping that ledge. The high teleport going to get him back into it. At least it's scary. The Ramrod going to save him. He needs to get back to center as fast as possible. You see these high teleports coming out from Luis every time. She's not even fucking with the ledge situation.
I think you're better off taking that damage from something like a dash attack or arm than you are potentially just dying off the side.
Absolutely. Min Min doesn't have a lot of good ways to threaten right above her, right? So Peckham either has to go further back to threaten that high recovery with the arms or try to get something a little bit less rewarding like an up air or an up smash.
Oh, man.
Cool. The movement. Spaghetti? Cool, man.
Go out there. Oh! The untackable!
The megawatt catching the drop from ledge, untackable at 100%. Jesus.
That's actually crazy. I think actually it was sub 100.
I think it was. I think it was 100 after the hit. It's crazy. Peckham taking game number three. Damn, Peckham up 2-1.
And this is a position where I was saying you're going to be a lot more chilling. Luis is the one that has to approach,
Absolutely. Has
to make something happen here, where Peckham is perfectly fine just staying on the back burner and going back to that layer one.
Yeah, Luis, obviously a professional, right? But you got to wonder if the nerves are starting to kick in as the invader, you know, today and tomorrow. You got to wonder if that representation of NorCal is at all playing on his mind, or if he's just here to play
and
here to compete.
Hypothetically, if he does win against Peckham, there's literally, I have to play against Chase.
Yep.
I just lost to Chase.
Apparently, Chase told me earlier that Luis has never beaten him, which is a pretty crazy statistic.
Never, ever.
But that being said, Luis does not seem fazed in the slightest. Absolutely putting on a masterclass here in his game number four.
I'm gonna need to see like the Luis Fox or some shit, bro. Like,
bro, I missed the Luis Fox. That shit was hype. When you needed him most, the Fox appeared.
All right, explosive flame taking the first stock. He said, "Fuck my Fox, bro."
Louis Money firmly in control. Ooh, the down throw tech chase on the platform gonna get huge damage.
Oh, okay, trying to get four of them. The quadruple.
70% off stage.
Nah, this is a different kind of Luis.
This is a Luis on the verge of losing.
This is the Luis I saw when he was fighting all the Japanese motherfuckers.
So true. This is the Luis that beat me. That beat Mia.
Nah, for real.
Yeah. Man stood on business in that pre-local.
I'm having war flashbacks of this edgeguarding.
Peckham still have yet to take this first stock here in game number four. Up three stocks to one, 62%. Peckham needs an answer, he needs it fast. At this point, you're starting to think next, right? You're starting to think, okay, clearly he's adapted, how is he adapted? What can I pull out in this final game to bring this back and clutch out the set?
Luis, I think, didn't change anything other than like, okay, I'm actually hitting stuff.
Everything's just landing now.
Yeah, everything is hitting. The nairs are converting. The back airs are putting me in a good position to edge guard.
Oh, damn!
Reading
the
rolling.
Okay. That was saucy. He's just playing with some more sauce. I don't know what it is. Oh, good catch on the nair, but gonna give up stage control. That's crazy.
Just freestyle on him real quick.
Beckham still has yet to take his first stock. Coming close, but needs one more good hit from one of the strong arms. Oh my God, going deep. Pays off.
A footstool with Min Min sauce.
Bro, Peckham's the only Min Min I feel like could post a clip, and it would actually be a clip.
Yeah. I feel like for a while, Pink Fresh was also up there.
Oh, Pink Fresh 100% up there. I don't know. Oh my God, the deep nair.
Bro has sauce. He's black.
Bro, every time I see...
Okay, back throw will do this.
Yeah, that's it. Pink Fresh is definitely up there, but Pink Fresh has been playing Marth. I don't want to.
Yeah. But when the Min Min was around, it wasn't sauceless. Like,
it was
that
not.
Shit kind of has sauce. One of the pioneers for Min Min. I'm sure Peckham would attest to that.
Absolutely. Yeah, I miss Pink Fresh. As a kid now, can't compete. Big shame.
Fair. He'll be back.
All right.
Game five.
No icy swap. For game number five.
No fucking need to do that. I think Icy's is not good in this situation. It did great versus Demon. Versus Luis, it's not gonna happen.
We'll see if Peckham was able to make the necessary adaptations from that game four. Clearly able to do it. Game five, can he clutch this out for SoCal? I'm surprised we haven't seen Palu Dare come into play at all during either of these sets. Tether just
actually
a little bit
getting
too,
the meteor spike.
Yeah, Tether just a little bit too tricky to time.
Oh!
I jinxed it.
You spoke too soon, brother.
Shit. Sorry, Backroom.
God damn.
Oh, man. And he's dead again. Wow, the drag down there into that fair. Laughing in the player cabs. Having a good time. Peckham never gets salty when he loses. Super respectable.
Yeah, he. I give you that. I give it up.
If he can take this stock right now, he's got a fighting chance, but I don't know, man. Against Luis?
It's looking like different beasts, same animal.
Absolutely. Yeah, he needs like this stock into like a zero to death edge guard. Took the stock.
We take one. It all starts with one.
This is bad. Okay. See, Luis, not even fucking with it, knows that it's a possibility, just goes high.
See, it just sucks because Min Min is known as one of those characters that doesn't have that comeback factor.
Right. She's not a Kazuya, she's not a Luigi, she's not a Touch of Death character. She's just impressive at what she does. But when she's
an advantage character.
Right.
Yeah.
But when she's behind, getting that, making up that ground is so hard.
I like to say it's not impossible, it's just improbable.
Definitely.
Damn, what a jab to catch that run up.
Yeah, Peckham's been getting up a lot and gets caught with the up smash for it. Damn. Luis taking that game five. Good set.